And now back to our studio, and I have two guests right now. One is CryptoRobby, which was our first guest, and joining us also Marko, which is CEO of SportyCo. And first, we're going to be talking about your initiative, yeah?
Yes.
It's called Return on Society.
Yeah. Return on Society.
Good.
And it's an initiative which kind of caught me, it came to me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because I see in this blockchain sphere a lot of projects which are just focusing on making money, making the rich people richer, really focusing on this money part of blockchain. But blockchain is much more. It goes far beyond of this money application. And that's how I found we need something which is gives something back to society. We need blockchain use cases with an added value to society. And I came from I worked for a humanitarian organization many years ago. I come from this charity thing. And even in research, I worked in research. We tried to make projects, research projects, which help people, which really matter to people. That was a big focus. So it's sometimes you lose yourself doing something completely technology focused. You have not this broad view. And what I try, and that's why people invite me to conferences, and you mentioned in the beginning mm-hmm. that I'm at many conferences, which yes, I am. And I tell these blockchain people and startups, why are we doing this? Why are we sitting here and working on a project? And it is to give an added value to society, finally. That's my opinion, to bring something to the society, make society better, make people's lives better. And I call this hashtag mm-hmm. return on society, because it's borrowed from return on investment, which mm-hmm. is necessary. We need return on investment. And we need also to make profitable projects. But it's also very important to have a return on society, to not lose this focus. And with projects, it's also the case that sometimes we forget this pure idea. Yeah?
The intention of
yes.
the beginning,
yes.
the purpose.
Very much. Mm-hmm. I remind this. That's my biggest focus.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, return on society. It's even conferences have been uh-huh. called industry blockchain applications with a return on society. So they use it, and it's for free. It's for free. They're open source. Everybody can use return on society.
Good. So this whole movement is your way of thinking it, or you feel it as it returns back on society. It
exactly.
gives back.
We shall do things mm-hmm. which have an added value to society. Mm-hmm. It shall not only be focused on money making, profit
yeah.
making.
Okay.
Of course, every startup needs to make profit. It must, in the long run, they must be profitable.
But as I remember on our first talk today,
yes.
you said we are actually combining or making hope, or let's say
yeah.
that's
yes.
hope we're actually boosting here.
Of course. I mean, hope, and we hope for a better future, but
mm-hmm.
we can also shape the future. We
there
are here
go.
To shape the future, and we can give hope to people, to other people, by the means of technology, in this case, blockchain technology, and we also can use it for sports,
mm-hmm.
supporting sports with this technology. That's where I see it. And that's why I think also SportyCo that's why I'm on board with SportyCo. And Marko was so nice to invite me to this project, because it has a clear return on society. It gives an added value to society. It helps young athletes to boost their mm-hmm. careers, and you said it also, you mentioned it already, and we heard the talks from Philip Nahn
mm-hmm.
and all the other speakers, even Kevin focused on that. It is important to support young athletes, and it's a new way to support them. It's a surprise.
It's a movement,
yes.
isn't it?
Yes, yes.
What would you say, Marko? How do you see SportyCo? Where is the ship going?
Yeah, absolutely.
Direction.
I completely agree with what Robby said. So the goal of SportyCo is to help young athletes, you know, on the most crucial point of their career, when it's very difficult to find enough money to support and to cover all the costs of travel mm-hmm. expenses, coaches, and all other stuff that every young athlete needs in order to become a superstar. So yeah, SportyCo platform is a great help for them. It's maybe the only option that some of them will have in the future to have the opportunity to become future superstars. So because we are solving such a big problem in the sport industry, that's why we are also able to attract so many big superstars to support SportyCo, to become our ambassadors. And yeah, in the future, of course, I can promise that many more superstars will join SportyCo, you know, to let people know about.
I think that's also for the younger crowd, it's important, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
to have these idols that they can follow, a hope, give hope to them.
Yeah, but you know what? All of them were facing the same problem when they were young. Somehow they were lucky, you know, that they found someone who supported them, and they become a superstar. And they understand this problem, and of course they would like to help other young athletes to become successful. So yeah, I'm very happy that, of course it's very tough, because at SportyCo we are building a completely new industry. Because on one hand we are helping young athletes, clubs and teams to raise funds. On other hand, we are allowing fans and small investors to invest into sport, which was impossible till now.
Beautiful.
So we need to work hard, you know, talk a lot about the opportunity that SportyCo is giving to young talents, and of course, you know, hoping that people will understand the opportunity that they have to support young talents. And of course, we would like to spread this industry and make it happen.
Raising a new sports tribe, actually, in the world. Yeah?
Yeah, 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 of course. We are building a completely new sport community that is willing to help young athletes in order that they will be successful. And of course, in the best way, of course, also to earn something from their success. Why not? If they support young talent, so if the young athlete will be successful, why not having a part of his earnings? But yeah, of course, it's a tough job for the moment because we are building a new industry. But I can see very positive feedbacks, and I think the SportyCo has a bright future. So yeah, we have several. New exciting partnerships coming, and we will see what the future brings to SportyCo.
Beautiful. You have any wrap-ups for today's summit? How do you feel this movement? Where is it going? Or what would you like it to be?
I mean, I'm involved in other blockchain projects like energy, real estate. I help them to build up this. With sports, first of all, you asked me about my beloved sport. It's ice hockey, which I play. So I feel I can do something for an industry, also something, a hobby, which I love, to
See,
boost it.
He already calls it industry.
Yeah,
great.
Right,
good.
Right. I mean, Kevin mentioned it's a $600 billion industry. I mean, we could hear his speech. It matters. On the one hand side, but it's still a hobby too. So I can have my hobby and support it with this project in a very new way, in a very disruptive way, because we have not seen. And Marco, you mentioned that the small investors can really directly invest in prospering or athletes, which have obviously probably a good career and have future. And so to wrap up, I see that SportyCo has already some big fans, like Ronaldinho, you know, it's big names joining. Like Philipp Nunn, he's really well known. I chat often with Philipp Nunn, he's really one of the big blockchain blockchain influencers. I also do a bit part to support it. And we really, from the blockchain side, support this project. There is, from the sports side, big support. And you mentioned there is some more to come. I'm very interested who will join next.
Marco.
So I will
stay tuned.
Okay.
Stay tuned.
And so it is from technology side and sports side, both we could hear this today. And that seems SportyCo will have a great future. I believe that.
The future looks bright, doesn't
yes.
it?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm very happy. I love sport. So I'm very happy that also blockchain technology is helping sport industry to improve. That's great. And that's why we are so, that's why SportyCo has organized this summit. And from the all the speeches that we heard today, I'm extremely happy that, you know, sport industry is one of the industry that blockchain can impact a lot. So I'm extremely happy. And also that SportyCo is giving, that we are giving our part in order to implement blockchain into sport industry. So we will do our best also in the future. I hope that a lot of other young companies, especially blockchain-based companies, will enter sport industry, and that we all together make sport better for all of us.
Thank you very much, guys. And I have to say, I'm very grateful and humbled to be a part of this great movement and industry, and your idea, actually, that combined us all. And World Sports Blockchain Summit, at least, and its first incarnation has come to an end. And a big, big thank you to all the speakers, of course, in with me today, either in my studio or via phone or Skype or however we heard each other. And of course, to everyone tuning into our live stream. And don't forget, the team and some of the speakers are available for a chat on our Telegram channel, so don't miss that. And that was all from us. My name is Anya. Thank you, and see you on the next summit. Till then, sport on.